the last flower in this release is the trillium. Trillium is a forest flower, let's call it, because it loves the shade. It's actually the national flower of Ontario, and it's against the law there to pick trilliums. So be careful if you're in Canada. The trillium symbolizes, for some people, the Christianity of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, because of the three petals. It's also known as wake robin, and why it's called that is because it usually appears before you'll even see the robins of the spring in the springtime come. So let's here's the die, and so you're going to cut one of the larger three petals. That's the flower. Now I'm doing them in white, but they come in red and pink. The red ones are actually medicinal and are used in to help break up congestion and some remedies. It has a little three leaf underneath of it, and then other leaves. So they can grow low to the ground, or there's some varieties that are somewhat bushy. So the white one, I'm going to add a little bit of green shading to the center there with some pan pastel and set that aside there. And then it has already the markings or the debossed lines, but I'm gonna put this on my molding pad first, and I wanna soften the petals. So I'm using my leaf tool. This is the small leaf tool. And I've got it face down, meaning right side down on the molding pad. But I want to bring in my leaf pad and grab my leaf tool. And I want to go over that because those debossed lines are very distinctive. Those kind of like the lily that we've done before. So you want to add those three lines down the center. So now we're going to take our tweezers and we're going to pinch right at the beginning there. And I'm going to actually hold that pinch and turn it around this way. I want to roll down those edges a little bit. And then right at the tip here, I'm putting my tweezer and I'm going to hold it and just pinch around to make that point. So we can do that again on this one. These they grow in northern part of North America. Actually, Appalachia has some of the most abundant trillium gardens. But it's going to be a pretty one to add because of its unusual shape to your bouquets. Now I'm going to take my small ball stylus and cup that one. And what I want to do is I want to place it into a tray to mold it a bit so it keeps its shape before I put it on my project. But before I do that, the little leaf that's underneath of it, I'm going to color that. Let me grab my in here. I'm going to add a few strokes of this greener color and then lighten it up. As kind of a yellowish green leaf to them. I like the way the alcohol pens shade really well. And then I'm gonna color on this back side. These go together really quickly because there's not much to them. So again, with the leaf pad, I'm going to take and place this right side down, grab my leaf tool, and going to add that stem line right down the center. And I'm going to do that to all three of these petals, or three of these leaves. Actually, I'm going to bend this around this way. These are a little more narrow, so you might want to use your very detailed tweezer to bend it down. And then let's grab the lighter green here to accentuate that stem. And then I can bend it back up again. It really shows up when you bend back and forth on that line. Now this one will also get cupped, so I'm going to grab that small ball stylus again and cup it. And then let's grab a little bit of glue here. This is the kid's choice. So now you just want to put some on your white flower and you want to line it up so you've got those leaf petals right in between. And I'm going to press down a little bit to catch it. And then this is just a little egg carton. I think you can get them online. They're for quail eggs to kind of hold it in place while I do the rest of it. It has a yellow stamen, and I cut that out of yellow cardstock, and I'm just going to take glue with a toothpick and just cover a little bit right around the center there, or the bottom part, the straight part. And then take your tweezer and roll it up tightly. I roll it a couple times in my hand and pull it off, just so I know that glue locks in place. And I'm just going to kind of flare out those little filaments, and then you can dip in the glue there. Make sure they're all, missed one right there. And then this is the pollen. Now you can get the pollen at Spellbinders. So this is the yellow pollen. And then I'm going to take and bring in my flower. And then just a little bit of glue on the bottom and set it right in the center there. Hopefully it let go there. Oh, I didn't get enough glue on there, so it came off. Make sure you really lock that in place. There we go. And set it down. I'm actually going to color these leaves, and I've got YG97, it's a darker yellowish green. These have some very unusual veining on them, and I'll show you how I get to that. Now I want to blend this color so you've got just that lighter shade in there. This comes with, you can cut your leaves, you can cut as many as you want. There's two here, but I would probably cut 4 to 6 because they are a very leafy plant. So you could certainly add more leaves than what I have. I color both sides with the alcohol inks. You could have also cut these out of green cardstock and shaded them up. I just thought I'd give you a alternative, and I have used my paper. So I'm gonna set these down, face down, right side down, and grab that leaf tool, and you're going to go ahead and just right down the center, mix that stem line. We're gonna crease it in half. Make sure you get it pinched all the way. And then add some brighter yellow color. And I'm just adding that out on the, shading out a little bit on the leaf as well. Now, like I said, this has a little unusual. So take your leaf tool, and with your veining, you want to kind of add extra little veining. It's not just straight lines coming out, but I'm adding these extra little curly things because it does have you know, very, almost like, I don't know, a lacy pattern, you know, so you've got more lines on it than just simply, let's see if I can grab a leaf here and I'll show you, just instead of, like, this is a leaf from one of the other plants, you know how we just do straight out, these you're going to, and there's your stem line, you're going to go out but add another little branch to it, just so it really imitates that pattern that's on those leaves. Then we're going to pinch at the stem line and grab your medium ball stylus and your molding pad and add that shaping to it. My hands get so much glue on them. There you go. So let's bring a project in. I've got a bouquet of them done here. And I'm gonna make sure these are raised up so when this closes, I'm going to add this one here, add a little bit of glue to the bottom, and then just simply lock it in place. You can fold that out like this, and grab a little bit more glue. And like I said, I could have done a lot more leaves on this one, but oops. I'm gonna make sure it's not dripping. And I've added, we've got from the quotes there, thinking of you. This, I'll just have to make sure these are up when I close this to send, like that. And then on the back, I put my quote, love is the flower you've got to let grow. You could also put on this card a panel here to sign as well. But it makes for an interesting little bouquet. Now we just have to do the ladybug. So I've got my ladybug here. I'm gonna grab my trusty, well-used art gum eraser and a small ball stylus and just cup her a little bit, pressing down on her body. I think I'll put her right out here on this. And grab my glaze. Always got to check, make sure your glaze is going to come out before you try it on your project. And there you have it, the trillium. Beautiful flower that makes a bouquet of along itself or in with other of the spring flowers, the wake robin, the one that's before the robins even show up.